Hello everyone, I am Vishal Soni. Today we're gonna build a smallest CPU which is not for heavy processing, but you can run a Arduino IDE. Requirement for this project are a Raspberry Pi 0W, a case for Raspberry Pi 0W, a heat sink for our processor, a charging and booster module which is 134N3P, a cooling fan for our processor, a 3.7V 1000mAh battery. Remember that more ampere rating will give you more battery backup. Now we will put Raspbian OS, which is Linux based OS, in our SD card. So take a SD card, make sure it is empty or formatted with FAT32. Now put this SD card into your card reader. Now connect this card reader to your PC or your laptop. Download the Raspberry Pi Imager tool from the link given in description. As you can see, this is the Raspberry Pi tool. Now click on the choose option. Here you can choose many of the OS which is provided by Raspberry Pi Imager. You can see there is Ubuntu and many more OS you can choose according to your Raspberry Pi. Or 0 is not for heavy processing, so we will choose Raspbian OS 32-bit. Now select your mass storage device. You can see this is 15GB and click on the write button. The writing process will take 10 to 15 minutes. This is depend upon your card speed, card reader speed and USB port speed and also your processor speed. Once it done, it will say to remove your SD card. Put your SD card into your Raspberry Pi. Now we will do a one-time setup so we can get rid of our mouse and keyboard. Connect mini HDMI to HDMI adapter and then connect HDMI cable to your TV or your monitor. For mouse and keyboard, you can use this type of OTG hub or you can use one by one mouse and keyboard like me. So I am using this OTG cable. Connect it to our USB port. Now connect a micro USB power cable which is mobile charging cable. At the beginning you will see a colorful screen. After some time you will see a Raspberry Pi logo. And then you will see a setup screen. Setup time zone. Don't forget to tick US keyboard. Connect it to your hotspot or same Wi-Fi where your mobile is connected. Now I have to remove my mouse and connect the keyboard to type the password. Once Wi-Fi is connected, now come to the other side of screen. Here click on the option and then preferences and then Raspberry Pi configuration. Here click on the interfaces and then enable VNC. Now scroll your cursor on the Wi-Fi icon. You can see the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. Now download VNC Viewer in your mobile phone from Play Store. You can find link in description. Open the VNC Viewer and click on the add button. Here type IP address of your Raspberry Pi. And you can give any name as you want. Now click on the connect. Now it will ask for username and password. Username is Pi and default password is Raspberry. I have changed it to 123, but you can use Raspberry. You can see here is our monitor screen on our mobile. Now we don't need a mouse, keyboard and any OTG adapter. Just power up your device and connect it to your hotspot or Wi-Fi. Then you will see screen on your mobile. Now we will make a portable case for our Raspberry Pi. Take our case and remove the pin marks on it from thinner or isopropyl. As you can see, all marks are gone. Now take a heatsink and put it just top of your processor. Make a square right edge of your heatsink. You can see the square as I made. Cut the square by heating up a sharp object. Smooth it with sandpaper. As you can see, I have made 4 holes to mount our mini cooling fan right top of our heatsink. Now put Pi in the case and remove sticky film from the heatsink and stick the heatsink on the top of our processor. We have removed the USB terminal from the module and soldered the wire on the V and G pin. So it will connect to the Pi and solder 2 more wire to the B plus and B minus, which we will connect to the battery. I have forgot to mention this light switch at the beginning, but I am presenting here. So I will use it to on off our device. Made a space to fix the USB terminal of our charging and booster module. Alone hot glue is not able to hold it on the place, so I have used super glue with it. Now we will connect our circuit. Connect positive terminal at the B plus and negative terminal at the B minus. Now we will connect a slide switch. Connect V pin to the side of slide switch and middle pin will connect to the Raspberry Pi. The ground is connected to the ground of Raspberry Pi. You can see pin diagram here. You can find 5V and ground here. Now fix all the things at the place. As you can see, I have placed the fan here. You can see here is the hole for SD card. Here I have made a hole for switch. Here you can see the charging and booster module. We have made the custom hole. You can also power it from power port. Here all the holes for ports like USB and power port. You can see my battery is pretty small because it is 300 mAh battery. It will give me a 5 to 7 minute of time, but you can increase it with 1000 or 2000 mAh battery or more. As you can see, I have installed Arduino IDE and it is working pretty well. Let's set up default resolution of our Raspberry Pi. Whenever you turn on the Raspberry Pi without screen, the resolution is pretty small. Let's turn on the Arduino IDE. As you can see, the upload button is not able to visualize.
So we have to screen the resolution so we can see the upload button. Now turn on command terminal and type this line and hit enter. Here uncomment the HDMI force hot plug equal to 1 and uncomment HDMI group 2 and HDMI mode. Now write 2 in front of HDMI group and 82 in front of HDMI mode. You can see your code of resolution in link given in description. Now press Ctrl X, Y and enter. Now type sudo reboot to apply the changes. Now open it again. As you can see, resolution is pretty good. Let's turn on Arduino IDE. Now you can see the full screen of Arduino IDE. You can see the compilation and upload button.